I think body cameras are probably a really good idea. I believe it protects both the officer and a suspect, if you will. I'm not going to call him a victim, but I'll just say a suspect. The only concern, or one of the concerns I have, though, with the mandate for body cameras is that if it's mandated, then who's going to pay for that? And that's my job to look out for the budget, you know, to try to figure out where the money's going to come from. That's one of my concerns. I think they can be a lot of help. They can give a better idea of exactly what's going on or what went on. But then the flip side of that is, if the camera fails, does that mean we don't really have a testimony or have anything to go on? So that would be a concern of mine.
I would just like to say congratulations, I think, to our county sheriff for taking quick action with the body camera for his deputies. I think that's probably a good move, and puts him kind of at the forefront, leading edge maybe of some of the counties around using body cameras. So I congratulate him for that.
I think it's a good idea to have body cameras. It eliminates a lot of witnesses seeing different things and reporting different what's going on during the confrontation, if there is, and the camera speaks for itself.
In my opinion, it's sad that we have come to that this day and age, but I think, and this is my personal opinion, I think within the next 5 years, it's come to the point that every law enforcement agency across the United States will be wearing body cameras simply to protect themselves. Since this mess down at Ferguson, there are a lot of characters that will attempt to set you up to get their 15 minutes of fame, or just because of the way or the feeling across the country right now, it's just very dangerous for an officer to be out there without a body camera.
I think it would be an asset for the city, for the police officers and the public. I'm all for them, 100%. I think it would be great.